Hello folks, Scott Ionita here again with Levitation 4. If you didn't see my last video, check it out. It describes Levitation 4 and its slad wings in more detail. Today I'm going to demonstrate the advanced performance of the slad wings on short takeoff and landing ability of this extraordinary aircraft, and I have just the place to do it. I parked my plane in a marina on a very windy river, and I have some cool takeoffs and landings on this river to show you today. I saved the best and shortest landings for the end of the video, so stick around to the end, it's only about 6 minutes. If you haven't already done so, please subscribe and click the notification bell. I intend to put out a new video every month or so, and your subscriptions make it worthwhile. I bought my airplane in Northern Quebec in January, and in May I flew back and put floats on it. Then I flew back to my home base in Ontario, a 3-hour trip with a headwind. I wasn't sure about landing in the river, I'd just gotten my float ready and wanted to be safe. So I landed in the bay and taxied 13 kilometers all the way up the river, which took over an hour and probably about 3 or 4 gallons of gas. That was the last time I was going to do that. The next day I checked the map for takeoff distances and I took off from the first suitable straightaway. I was off the water in less than half the distance available to me, and landing takes less distance than the takeoff, so I soon realized that I could land the takeoff from pretty much anywhere in the river. I'm usually flying at about 65 knots from my final approach. Sometimes I get down to 55 knots on my short final. I don't feel comfortable flying any slower than that, even though the stall speed on this aircraft is 35 knots with the full flaps extended. I'm mainly just showing the takeoffs and landings in this video. The parts you don't see are the precautionary passes and the circuits. Anytime a pilot plans to land on a lake or a river or a field, he must first conduct what's called a precautionary pass. This is typically done at about 500 feet above the ground and just off to the side, so you can see what's on the surface where you plan to land. In this case, I will check to make sure there are no boats, no floating logs, or a flock of geese in the river. After that, I will climb to 1,000 feet and form a circuit for my final approach. I am on the base leg of the circuit, or the pattern. If you watch the leading edge of the wing, you will notice the slat begin to open. As the plane slows down, the wing's angle of attack increases. The slats help the air stick to the top of the wing and increases the wing's lifting performance.
No flaps.
This isn't a northern lake, but you have to admit, it is beautiful. Late in the day with the sun going down and this beautiful glassy water, just gorgeous.
Flaps at 20%, carbine's in.
When I went to look at this airplane with the intention to buy it, Michael LeQuinn, who owns Tapanee Aviation, the manufacturer of this aircraft, was the one to take me on my first test flight. The runway was covered with snow, and Michael was the pilot in control for the landing. His approach was around 45 miles an hour. That's 39 knots. That's way too slow for me. Michael has a lot more experience than I do, of course, and he was showing me what this aircraft is capable of. As the summer progressed, I was gaining more and more experience on this aircraft. By the end of the season, I had 85 hours on floats and 135 hours on Levitation 4. The theory behind landing is to pick a spot partway down the runway where you intend to land, then focus on it, and use a mark on a windshield to keep it on that spot where you intend to land. You may notice in the first of these two clips, I was aiming partway down the straight stretch of the river. In the second clip, which was later in the season, I was aiming for the shoreline. That gave me a lot more room left over after the landing. Well, that's all for now, folks. I hope you enjoyed the video and I hope to see you in the next video. I have the annual aircraft maintenance video coming out soon. If you liked this video, please check out the last video I posted, How Slatted Wings Improves the Performance of Short Takeoff and Landing of a Float Plane. Please don't forget to subscribe.